Afternoon, one and all. This is the second session of second day of International E-Dialogue. Rotarian Pratim Banerjee is a member of Rotary Club of Jamshedpur West. He was born in Nuremberg, Germany. He is an engineer by profession and is a life member and patron of many professional, social, and cultural organizations. He is elected as the district governor of RID 3250 for the Rotary year 2021-22. His bag is full of recognition. I am here to highlight something. In the year 2019, he is awarded as Best Club Secretary, Rotary International Citation for Avenue of Services, again in 12-13, Best Club President, and got 33 Rotary International and District Awards. Year 2013 and 14, Rotary International Award as Club Builder, graduated from Rotary Leadership Institute and qualified as a trainer. In year 2015-16, District Outstanding Assistant Governor. In year 2017-18, Rotary Foundation Citation for Meritorious Service. Rotarian Pratim and his spouse, Rotarian Suchanda, are Rotary Foundation major donor and their two children are PHFS. Pratim is married to and ably supported by his wife, Rotarian Suchanda, who grew up and did her pre-university in East Africa. She is a part-time educationist and award winner philatelist and a leading numismatic. They are blessed with two children, Mukta, now employed with Spareliner, Hamburg, Germany. And their son, Chirag, is now working for Northern Trust, USA at Bangalore. Attended Sydney, Seoul, and Hamburg convention and 8 district conferences and 12 international club meeting. He visited more than 50 international cities and towns of 21 countries. Here, we welcome Rotarian Pratim Banerjee.
So, do I start, please?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So, good afternoon, everybody. Good afternoon, my young friends. Good afternoon, my friends in Rotary, Rotarians, and everybody. Salam to my DG, Rajan. So it's just a wonderful, again, occasion for me to speak to you all. And although apparently the subject which has been just said out, that have you taught yourself about, have you taught how to learn about yourself? Apparently it seems to be a bit dull and difficult subject. But anyway, I'll drive you through it and try to make ease and more sense out of it and do some good if at all it is to be accepted by you all. So at the onset, I would request that video to be played, which is much relevant to the of the narration which I'm going to make. So Abhishek, could you please? Isn't that wonderful? Don't be afraid to walk alone, isn't it? Now, I'll give you a situation whereby I'm asking you not to be afraid to walk alone. Now, one thing we have to understand that you Rotaractors or all the youngsters, you are mostly, while you are in school or you're in college, you are all covered up and protected by your education institution, by your parents, by your relatives, by the world around, each contributing something or the other to groom you up to be eligible to be alone. And then once, at one moment of life, when you have to start on your own, you're all alone. And this is the most important starting point. Don't be afraid when you are alone, and you can only be not afraid if you really know about yourself. Say, I'll give you a situation. Suppose you are on a bike and you're moving through in the evening through a jungle or some kind of hostile place, and all of a sudden something goes wrong with the bike and you can't move ahead. So the next you know, just about 2 kilometers ahead is a small village where you can take refuge. So that is the time you have to take a decision what to do. Now, if you have the ability to run, then you can run up to the next village, stay the night, protect yourself, take care of yourself, and next morning you can come up back to your bike and redo it and continue your journey. But if you are not a good runner, then maybe you are a good climber. So you could then take a decision that I'll climb up a tree, stay the night up there, see myself protected, and then in the morning, I'll seek help and carry ahead. Again, if you are not a really good climber and you're afraid, possibly you are good with your skills to strike a fire without having anything, or to create a place for yourself of comfort where you can stay in the night and see the wild animals not coming over to you and making a mess of things. So it's only a situation where you know yourself and you can then accordingly take a decision. But what's the saddest part is, to know ourselves, none of us ever have been taught how to learn about ourselves, to live and work in our own terms. Again, I repeat, none of us usually, I mean, there might be some exceptions, have never ever been taught how to learn about yourself. So this is where my narration starts. I want only if we learn about ourselves as of now, through trial and error. But the better we know ourselves, we do and lead a life more efficiently. Now I'm going to break it up into a few segments, which I'll draw you through down in my deliberation. And with each segment, you have to build up yourself on these subjects. Now let me start with your first is your personal productivity. You are taught to work in those ways which might not be natural to you as an individual. Say, if you're going to work, you're going to do it with 9 to 5. But if you realize for yourself, your best peak time is morning 7 o'clock to 12 noon. So here, what you have to find out for yourself is what you have to value here is the quantity of work you do and not the amount of time you spend. If in a day, my happiness should be of the quantity of work I do and not on the amount of time I spend. So when this 9 to 5 thing comes in, to very many, it causes a stress. So we have to bring in ingredients of productivity, which is very different from each other. It's not about managing time, but it is managing your limited energy. Definitely for sure, it is being understood that human beings' energy is limited in a per day quota basis. So a 10 hour of work is not important, but those 3-4 hours of energy that you have to rightly utilize it to create a high quality of work. So this is about personal productivity. The second issue is, do you know your why? Beyond your money, if you're working, why do you do the work you do? You have to know that why. Cultivate the habit of asking why. Why? Because it's the easiest and the most effective self-awareness question you can ask. Why, where, when, what, how? The more you ask yourself, the answers will be yours and you'll be more productive and creative. So why is a very important thing you have to ask yourself to build up on your personality. Now, again, another thing is, what are your values? What's important to you? I mean, values, that is how we will put it in a different phrase. It's the kind of work you're willing to do and not to do. So if my value system tells me that I am to do these kind of things, I'll do it. And if your value system doesn't say, say something like, you know, which is not right, so you don't do it. So values is your personal code of conduct, which is guiding you in your actions and your responses to any circumstances. That is your value, and you have to know your value. Values, I will put it in another phrase for your better understanding, is the foundation and blueprint for living your why. I just spoke to you about why. Now, this is provides a foundation and blueprint for living your why. So, say for example, when you buy a physical product, now that's the time when your value comes in. And you ask yourself a question, will it enhance my experience or is going to detract me from them? Values are actions for the best use in matters of time and energy. So you have to constantly seek ways of, if you have a good value system, so bring in your value system to reduce the number of decisions you have to take per day. And you reduce the number of steps in a process. Now, every day we are coming up with decisions. If you have a right value system, so your ways, and you reduce the number of decisions, because all your decision making, which is based on your values, is already predetermined. Now, another factor is motivation. Now, that's a huge thing which is very important for us. If you are a working person, the first thing we would say is, what is your motivation to do it? I would say, money. But of course, that would be a very general thing. If I'm to ask a chat query to everybody, is what's the most motivating thing for you to do your work? You'll say money. But possibly, there would be other motivations for you, like working with others or be in competition. That's what motivates you. Or maybe helping others is a motivation for you. Or maybe solving problems is a motivation for you. So what is motivation is how you live your why. Again, let's go back to that why I was just talking about. And act in alignment with your value system. So, how to harness the power of your motivation is to provide with a sustainable source. Because motivation is kind of a fire. It has to be complemented with a source of energy. Energy has to be going in to fuel your motivation. So you have to find out that. Now, another big factor for every one of us is how to learn. Because constantly we need to learn new skills beyond our academic institutions to thrive in a daily, dynamic, changing world. The one thing is for assured, for those people who are under 35, please be assured that you are in India, you are 50% of the population. So you have to be a learner. So 50% of India's population is below 35. That means this 50% of the 133 crore Indians are people who are aspiring to go ahead in life. Now we have to have a better understanding of the near future and the distant future. Say for now, lots of new things are coming in. Lots of new technologies are coming in. In another 5, 7, 10 years, it says the world will be running mostly on battery cars. In the coming years, fossil fuels will be reduced. People will no more be using conventional energy sources like electricity and other means. We will be more into solar and natural energy sources. Things like being a lawyer will not be any more important. Doing a BA, BSc, BCom will be of no importance or any of significance. Artificial intelligence will be the call of the day when the world will be operating and helping human beings to operate and do things. So many things are coming up, and you have to learn about it to keep yourself on the right side. Like you see now, school kids are now doing coding, and they are coming up with apps because that's the call of the learn, and they're learning it rightly. And you'll see these television ads that it's about this children learning ads to how to make apps. That's the call of the day, and this is you learn because the necessity is there. In schools, we fear learning because we are not given a choice to align ourselves. Now, what has school taught us? Read, memorize. What is our motivation in school? Why should you read and memorize? You will get good grades. Now, this is not the way it should happen because you might not be suited for it. So, the motivation by grades is a thing which is not really suitable for most of us. Now, motivated by opportunities and to experiment is the call of the day. So, continuing on this learning, what motivates you to learn something new? There has to be a motivation to learn, isn't it? Because if you don't learn, if life goes on as good than learning, then why go in for it? But there should be a motivation. It is to experiment and learn your mistakes. That is what is called learning. Or, say for in school, reading, you don't like reading. Okay, so what do you like? How do you learn? For me, maybe it's, if I listen, I learn a lot. So that I would go in for lectures and hear people talk. So that gets into my ear and I learn more. But maybe for some, it must be the visuals which must enables them to learn more. So then you track it out that you see these videos or YouTubes and you do all your visual learnings. The method doesn't matter as long as it's in line with your motivation and your learning style. Another important factor is your habits. Your habits are very important. It tells you how you spend your time, money, and energy. It assesses your habits and decides what to eliminate, what is your strength, and how to change it. There are quite a few of our habits to change them are very challenging. But if you do so, you will do good in life. Say like weight loss. Usually we are overfeeding ourselves on a universal basis. So there you have to do something to bring in some habits by which you'll get to the correct weight of your body or your sleeping patterns. The people who go very late in life to sleep and get late up in the morning, which is not something which you would be like to do it. So you have to challenge yourself to change these habits. Addiction of the TV and the mobile. Challenge yourself to change the habit. Spend money on purchases. Obviously, at the end, you do have a regret. Then challenge yourself to change it. Another important thing is your strength and abilities. Most of us limit our capabilities to the skill and experience we have in a resume. But there is more. You have to define your ability in what's your natural strength, talent, hard and soft skills, life experiences, hobbies, and marketable skills. That is when, if you have strength in yourself, it will do you good. One more important thing is your personality. Now, what do we mean by personality? If I may define, it's your natural tendency and preference for interacting with people and the world. I repeat, it's a natural tendency and preference for interacting with the people. Knowing your personality will help you to understand the world and how you would like to work with and what type of people you would like to work. So the moment how you like to work and with what type of people you work, if you understand it with understanding your own personality, you will be able to engage yourself. Now, next on, continuing on this personality, there is assessment. It's called Myers and Briggs. I think I'll share the link of this later. Each of you should go through this. And it will come up with the trait of personality. It is a questionnaire of 64 questions are there. You have to say like it or you disagree or you dislike it. And you go through the series of 64 questions and it will in conclusion throw up a personality trait of who you are. Please take those guidelines. It will do you good in life. The most important thing of what we have to understand for ourselves is
I think the bandwidth at Pratyanda house is a bit low, so we should wait for him to reconnect. Am I right, Abhishek?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
But he is connected. It's showing connected. Abhishek, ji, team connected so ho raha hai.
ये कनेक्टेड है सर, एक्चुअली बैंडविड्थ इशू है, ये अभी 10 सेकंड लेगा इनको 15 सेकंड दोबारा से रिफ्रेश करने में.
Yes, Pratim is back now.
But I'm not able to spot.
Oh, I got disconnected, is it?
Yes, sir. Are you back?
Abhishek, shall I continue?
Yes, yes.
Yes, we can hear you clearly, Pratim.
Shall I continue, please?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So I was saying about the personality, Myers and Briggs assessment you go through, it will be a fantastic thing where you can see the trait is.
Again, he left.
Pratim, stop your video.
He left.
Next time when he comes in, I'll tell him to stop his video.
Joined.
But he is here connected, he is showing connected.
Without audio.
Team, stop your video, then we can hear you uninterrupted.
Okay.
Yes, now continue.
Yeah, so next thing I was talking about was emotional intelligence. Now, earlier we had known that our IQ was a very important parameter for us to make a judgment of who we are and how we should perform. as a self-assessment. But that's an old school. Now the new thing is you have to assess emotional intelligence. Now, what is emotional intelligence? It's the ability to manage your emotions, effectively interact with people, capacity for empathy, and ability to focus. If you have an high emotional quotient, you are good in this. It is more of a sense of how you react to people, understand others' needs, minimize explosive reactions, and sustain your motivation. The next important thing of our perspective, which we should know, is our self-confidence. We have to abandon our predefined paths of our 9-to-5 style and create our own path, which takes confidence. It is like having a courage to experiment and learn from a mistake. Self-confidence helps us to hold back or to move forward in our own terms. So, looking at all this, another most dreaded thing which we always suffer from is fear. जिसको हम बोलते हैं डर. I would rather say face your fears, challenge your expectations. Holding back, you have to hold back your fears. You have to hold back your cravings, your negative desires, risks, and you have to unload them out of your system. If you have fear, you cannot progress because there'll be holdbacks. So you have to learn about yourself. If you want to be efficient, if you want to be productive, if you want to be a winner, if you want to be a challenger, you have to know about yourself under these broad parameters I've said ourselves. People know you by your CV, which says what your academics or what skills you have developed. But that is for them. But if you know yourself and you rightly know it, say for example, I'm a person who does not talk much. I like listening and doing things. I'm a backroom guy. But suppose I select a profession, which is a marketing profession, I head for a disaster. So if I know that I cannot speak, I'm not talkative, I'm not an extrovert, you'll definitely at the time of choice will not take up a career in marketing. If you are to be put on stage saying that, please do this, we are going to have a theatrical program and you have to enact this part, you have to be a Ram or you have to be this, we are doing Mahabharata. And you are an extremely shy person, you cannot talk to people in the presence of people. So you should know yourself that what you are capable of. But if you are good, you immediately jump and snatch out those opportunities. So the best and the most effective means to know yourself and to learn and build up your own personality is by starting with a habit of writing. Now, every day, you write in that old-fashioned journal, or you write on your phone, whichever tool suits you, the conventional or the technology. But do write the most positive and the most negative things, feelings which you had in a day. Be a student of yourself. Start taking notes. If you do this from day after day, day after day, day after day, you will come to understand who you are and what you are. And accordingly, as the situation comes, you'll be able to apply yourself and be in the lead. Again, remember, this country has 50% of 133 crores whom each everyone is trying to achieve something. So you are a person also of that race. And if you can, you'll be very, very successful. So, if I'm coming back to that opening statement, have you taught how to be how to learn about yourself. Pick up these bits and pieces from it. Definitely, I'm sure you cannot start going from here, but give it yourself a start. You learn about yourself, know your things, note it down. You will be successful in your life. So thank you very much. I'll not go further ahead on this. If ever at all you want to speak or ask me any questions, I'm just available. And thank you for this lovely opportunity. I felt I should be sharing this. It's a bit too serious thing. But again, if we are able to, through this Raila, able to make some positive impact through my deliberation, I think our purpose of this Raila will be done and we'll be successful. So that's how it is. I'm really thankful to all the organizers, and Mr. Rajan, and everybody who is into it, my club.